So I'm here to present a specific case of a university in Greece, the largest university in the country, actually. I have identified with bits and pieces from all the presentations of the previous speakers in the session, and you will see in the presentation how we dealt with the same issues and what was our approach. So the full title is the case of the largest university in Greece and how integrating external tools to assist the community and facilitate international synergies. Regarding the structure of the presentation, first I say a few words about the university. I outline the challenges we faced, especially during the pandemic, the changes we made, the outcome of those changes, and what we intend to do in the future. So the university, as I said, is very large, but it's not a geographical issue. There are so many people, 50,000 students, 1,500 to closer to 2,000 staff, faculty. There are administrative staff and other teaching assistants, and all these entities are players in the e-learning system. So it's a very big university, and it's not a single faculty university. There are virtually every faculty that you can find in a university. And this is also important in the way we handle our LMS, because we have a single LMS for the entire university, unlike the guys, we have different installations. So this is the structure of the programs, and you see we have 43 undergraduate programs, 143 master's postgraduate programs, and some doctoral programs who fortunately are not really represented in the LMS. So which are the major challenges in such a scenario? It's the size of the community and the curriculum that is a challenge in itself. It's also the diversity of the fields of study, because they have different learning needs and they use different teaching tools. Also, there is a wide variance in digital skills levels. And then there was the pandemic. So everybody had to get on board and get on board immediately. And there was a wide, some schools were not really represented in the LMS. Others just had the courses open, but namely only to distribute PDFs, but suddenly they had to not only give lectures, but also exams via the LMS. So the shift was abrupt to exclusive online classes and online exams. Not currently so, but at the first year of the pandemic, it was so. The new challenges were many. There was the challenge of availability, because the system had to be up and running and have a good performance 24/7. There were security and privacy issues. There were also procedural issues and governance issues. There were legal issues involved in the exam process especially. And there were also usability issues. So what we did was change the structure, the hardware structure, the server structure of the LMS, and move to a clustered approach, because a monolithic approach was just not working with the number of users we had. And we did several other things on which I will focus in today's presentation. I'm not here to present our hardware configuration. So what we did was integrate Zoom better with Moodle, perform some content upgrades like math type to assist technological schools, use several plugins like the Safe Exam Browser plugin and plugins to block concurrent sessions. I already mentioned server clustering, and also we made enhancements to the people, to the user support team, the first level support team especially, because they had to handle all the load of instructors not being able to actually build their courses and contact their students, etc. And also we had to make sure that we were in line with legal restraints, and we had to approve several terms and conditions in online exams. Okay, regarding the Zoom integration, which is one of the key aspects of this presentation, we used Zoom Meetings dashboard configured as an external tool via LTI. The university uses single sign-on, I didn't mention this before, via SMAML for authentication. So we used these institutional accounts also for Zoom meetings, but we had to, we required a Zoom update to LTI Pro to ensure data privacy, because institutional emails are not meant to be displayed or propagated outside the actual institution. So Zoom complied with that and made an upgrade. Emails are cloaked currently. And Zoom was by far the most popular video conferencing tools. You can see, I hope, although not from far, the numbers for all the video conference tools. We used other tools as well, but Zoom was by far the most popular. The immediate outcome of the pandemic was that the community and the IT center rose to the challenge, and that was impressive. The pandemic was essentially an accelerator for digital skills improvement, but the interesting thing is what remains after that, and I will refer to that. The new server infrastructure greatly improved availability and user experience, and we got positive user feedback, and trust in digital tools really increased. I have a graph here of the statistics of assignments and quizzes activities in our Moodle installation, starting from 2019, way down there, and ending, this is the peak in September. The peak was June 2021. In September, because fewer people participate in exams in September, that's why the drop, the marginal drop is. Currently, where we have returned to in-person teaching and exams, there is a drop, but it's not in the old levels. It's around the 2020 levels. What other integrations do we have in our systems? The campus management system, or CMS, is another very important integration for Moodle because it contains all the information about the students. That's where they register and declare which courses they're going to attend, and that's where they get their credit units and they get their ultimately get their degree. We use a software developed in-house, an open source solution actually, it's called Universis, the initials being standing for Student Information Systems, which has web interfaces for everyone involved, school registration offices, faculty, students. So students go there and determine which courses they're going to attend each semester. And the LMS has to learn from that which students to enroll in which course. That integration is currently on the way. The current level is that students are enrolled automatically. I should say without manual involvement. I'm a developer, so I cannot say something that is not 100% true. It is automatic, but it's not an actual integration yet. So instructors in each course determine which class they want to connect to the LMS, and there is a synchronization script, as the previous speaker said. And we are currently, the development team of Universis is currently working on compliance with one roster, so we have an actual integration. Regarding international synergies, we have a project called Epicur Campus, which is an inter-university digital ecosystem where students from other European universities attend courses online in other universities, and the key in foreign country universities, and the key is that they use their original institutional accounts. They don't obtain another account from the other university. So we have two main modules in this project, the virtual campus learning platform and the virtual university registrar system. You understand that we need a common registrar system for all these universities because the students actually obtain credits for the courses they attend towards their degree. So the first piece of software plays the role of a decentralized learning management system, essentially, and apologies if any developers are here, essentially it's a course catalog, dynamic course catalog, it's based on Ilias LMS, and the other part is the centralized campus management system, which is developed in our university. So specific courses designated to be available to international students become available using their home country institutional accounts in the foreign country LMS, so in our Moodle. So we have such students and we can enroll them using the Campus Connect plugin, a custom configuration of the, Campus Connect plugin. Now, the pandemic, I'm not sure I can say it's over, but certainly we're at the next phase and we have to see the future. What we got from the pandemic era, we have a major positive shift in attitudes towards online learning. You have to have observed this everywhere. There's a legacy in digital content, in teaching material and exams content. There are amazing question banks in our Moodle currently. And the legal issues related to online learning, now we're talking about a non-online, non-virtual university, a traditional, if you will, university, they no longer seem that insurmountable as they did prior to the pandemic. We saw that many departments opted to, although not legally compliant, they opted to go around with workarounds to get over this obstacle of legal. The law says that the student has to be there for an exam, and the professors wanted to do the exam via Moodle. So what did they do? They got the students in computer labs, and they held the exams in computer labs. So no more correcting grades, nothing. Or they bought tablets, and they distributed tablets to the student, again in a university area. What are our future goals in terms of integration? We want to use LTI for all in-house developed code so we can distribute it and get outside opinions on our code and improvements, of course. We want to go towards a two-way integration with CMS at a lower level. Now, there are not only enrollments that are of interest in a CMS, we can also automate course creation. Currently, at the beginning of each academic year, course creation is not automated. We envision a future where the courses, as they have been declared in the CMS and their properties and the teachers and the assistants, everything is transferred to the LMS automatically. Now, there are several challenges involved, as you may imagine. We want to improve the current solution we have for student enrollments, and we want, in the other direction, to get information from the LMS to the SIS, to the student information systems, and update their grades. I personally worked on a piece of code for that. We have not yet launched it in production. What are our other goals for LMS? We want to streamline our updates. So that's your topic. We want to upgrade to Moodle 4, hopefully quite soon. And we want to better accommodate the needs of a part of the university that is not that much discussed in the rest of the presentation. The university has lifelong learning programs, so they have a different life cycle. They are not students who come to the university at 18 and graduate at a certain age. There are people who enroll in any time in their lives to obtain a qualification for some subject matter. The attendees don't have institutional accounts. They have different access rights. They have different timetables. So it's a challenging project to make sure that they are also properly served by our LMS. Thank you very much for your attention. And I have not written if you would like to ask any questions, but I would be very happy to answer if you have any. Sorry, I was worried I'd run out of time, so I finished ahead of time.
Thank you very much for your presentation. Regarding data privacy regulations, and the ModZoom plugin and other external tools, have you got a process to streamline overcoming these challenges? And we have made the experience that even at the beginning of COVID, we had some challenges to overcome, some people to convince, and ModZoom is a perfect example for us. We tried to implement it. We got Zoom at our university, we got Moodle, but it's taken until now and we haven't even yet done the integration. So some more insights into the data privacy regulations would be very...
Okay, they made an upgrade to LTI Pro component to make sure that institutional accounts are not displayed in Zoom. I should have put in a screenshot, and I should have talked slower, that's a different discussion. But I should have put in a screenshot that on a Zoom meeting using the institutional account. The email is hidden. There are like stars, only the beginning. AUTH is the name of the university, GR. And then there are stars in the account. It's hidden, it's not propagated to Zoom. Okay, so we are GDPR compliant on that. We couldn't be, we couldn't not be. Okay, we had to be in order to employ this solution. So this has been resolved in our case. And if you'd like, we can discuss the integration, because I think it's a very important integration, Zoom and Moodle. It was life-saving in the pandemic because it took in all the load and there were the classes. We also, I didn't also mention, initially my presentation was supposed to be shorter in the schedule, but I didn't mention that we have in place statistics and monitoring platforms, both for us, I am the administrator, and for the server management people, in order to pinpoint the load when we know we have an activity that will attract many students. We make sure that they are also watching and we see the load, and if we need to make changes in the infrastructure, currently it's holding up very well, we will. So we are on top of these things. And thank you very much for your question. I will be glad to discuss it further.